The woman we're calling Jane says her sexual abuse started at age 4, and shortly thereafter, her father put her in a child sex ring.
I don't know how old the youngest one was, but I guess to give it an idea, she was in diapers.
Jane says every few weeks, she and her brothers were forced to go to a secret campground near Orlando where they were sold to adults.
Me and my two half-brothers were sent to these camps. One of my half-brothers ended up dying at the camps because of the abuse.
Among the clients, she says, were a doctor, lawyers, and more.
There was a politician that was pretty high up, and there was an NBA basketball player.
Jane says the trafficking continued until she was 16 and she finally ran away, only to be tricked into a party where she was drugged and imprisoned.
I was chained up in the swing, and men would come in day and night and just do whatever they want to.
People are not aware of how prevalent human trafficking is.
Somi Ali has been working to help trafficking victims for 11 years.
Every 8 blocks from where we are, someone is being trafficked.
Somi's charity, No More Tears, takes up to 40 calls a day from law enforcement asking her to help yet another victim.
We had a case of a victim that told us she was trafficked in North Miami in an apartment for 8 years. The youngest girl that was there was 11, and the oldest woman was 65 years old.
Jane is one of Somi's clients, referred by the FBI, who have tried to investigate her claims about lack of physical proof. It's frustrating for her, but she is grateful just to be alive.
And for me to be here still today, I recognize that it's a miracle. And I do want to do my part as far as, like, reaching out and helping other people, men, women, and children, that are in trafficking situations.